Since the first half of 2020, the auto industry has been facing a systematic decline in production, primarily due to the COVID-19 pandemic that heavily impacted manufacturing for a long while and has since contributed to supply chain disruptions for most items, including auto parts. One of the casualties of this has been the crisis in the semiconductor industry, not only for manufacturing and supply chain disruptions, but also stiff competition from home computers as more and more people began working from home. For 2021 and 2022, the semiconductor chip shortage was primarily responsible for about 25 million fewer cars being sold than earlier forecasts suggested. About 135 million were actually sold versus forecasts of about 160 million units. The US market was one of the hardest hit, with early indications that 2023 may be even worse. For those considering purchasing a new car nowadays, waiting times currently range anywhere from 6 to 18 months for delivery, depending of course on the brand and the model. So what about the impact on the electric vehicle or EV segment? First, it is important to realize that EVs require about 10 times more semiconductor chips than gas-powered cars, upwards of 3,000 chips per EV versus about 300 chips in a gas-powered vehicle, like the Ford Focus. As such, you would expect the impact of the chip shortage to be much greater on EV producers. But in reality, this didn't occur in 2022. Frankly, the opposite occurred, where EV sales actually saw a positive sales trend, up 39% from 2021, with over 10 million EVs sold. Why did this occur? Well, part of the answer is driven by government environmental regulations, as they have increased pressure on automakers to slash carbon emissions. It goes without saying that the long-term demand for semiconductor chips is expected to remain very strong and is forecast to more than double in relation to current levels, reaching $1.4 trillion by 2029 in the base case scenario. In fact, it is still forecast to hit $1 trillion by 2030 in the low case scenario. Although the automotive semiconductor market represents about 10% of the total market, a trend that is expected to generally continue through 2030, it is overshadowed in comparison to computers and communications, which are much larger and more profitable. From a buyer's point of view, this segment is the real bottleneck. In the past, buyers were able to select suppliers and dictate terms and conditions, and contracts tended to be shorter, 6 to 12 months. Today, they try to transfer this into long-term conditions, but it has proved difficult as it has become a seller's market. Further, there is an issue with the standardization of technical specifications in leading-edge applications for chips in the smaller sizes, 14 nanometers or smaller, which are used, but not required, by many automakers. How will the situation of the shortage of chips, coupled with increased demand through 2030, be resolved, and when? The semiconductor industry actually reached 90% utilization in 2020, so it is deemed to be a mature industry. As such, many companies are currently mapping plans and laying out enormous investments to meet future needs. It should be noted that a new semiconductor fabrication facility takes about 5 years to build. So where is all the money going, and what are the timelines? Semiconductor Engineering did extensive analysis on this subject based on company reports for 2021 and 2022. This chart shows investment amounts by companies based on start of production dates. A total of $100 billion is expected to be invested over the next 5 years, from 2023 through 2027. The largest investors with the nearest start of production date in 2024 are Intel at $37 billion and Samsung, $17 billion. In conclusion, there is a chance the chip shortage will stabilize in 2024. However, to be able to overcome the crisis in the auto industry by then not only requires readiness from the semiconductor manufacturers, but also resolving the shortage of critical raw materials, standardization of technical specifications, and transitioning to long-term strategies in semiconductor manufacturing.